Following sanctions slapped by the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among on the boycotting legislators, the leader of opposition Mafia Simpoga has come out today to maintain that the ongoing boycott of plenary proceedings by the opposition remains alive until they extract a proper response on all the demands regarding the gross human rights violations, including explaining the fate of the 18 missing persons.
I want to again restate our position as the opposition in Parliament that we are not available. The days we gave the executive, once they expire, we shall one day return to the House to make another demand that they show us the burial grounds or the bodies of these missing Ugandans.
Addressing the press at Parliament, the leader of opposition punched holes in the Speaker's directives regarding them as a deliberate effort to divert them from the noble cause. Mpuga assured the public that the opposition boycott is fully supported by the Constitution and all the other laws, including the parliamentary rules of procedure.
We're not going to be invited in an exchange with the Speaker. Our demand of the Speaker is follow up her instructions to the executive, namely to come and respond. And it's not safe for us to engage into a sparring match with the Speaker, who is supposed to be a referee in this matter.
The Speaker banned the boycotting opposition lawmakers from participating in other parliamentary activities, including committee meetings, foreign and domestic travels, plus the upcoming East African parliamentary games. However, Mpuga asked legislators he leads not to be bothered by the travel restrictions that come with hefty allowances, since they are remunerated fairly well as people's representatives.
There's no constituency that's elected an MP on account of being an athlete or a footballer. So those small diversions, as political leaders in Parliament, we understand them, but we cannot be diverted.
Still, the Speaker started today's House sitting with a reminder that the countdown of the 15 sittings is on course, with 6 sittings down. The matter of the missing opposition legislators became a matter of discussion on the floor as NRM legislators castigated their counterparts for perpetual absence.
Just to make a kind reminder, today is the 6th sitting.
And there is sufficient laws in this country where someone is aggrieved and he reports it to either police or he goes to court. And in case he's aggrieved by the decisions of this House, he can follow it within the rules. So in that respect, can we appeal to our colleagues in the event that the cause of action was not by this House to take appropriate measures by reporting the matters where they are supposed to report them?
Dennis Hamson Obua, the government chief whip, informed Parliament that the opposition should not expect any further response from the government, claiming that all their grievances were addressed by the government. He asked the Speaker to use all options at her disposal to compel the opposition to return to the House.
It was given 30 days. But to the best of our recollection, we have explained, honorable members, this is the same list that was submitted to Human Rights Commission. Same list submitted to a parliamentary committee that reported on the floor. Same list investigated by the different agencies of government. For how long will this parliament continue with this legislative activism?
Colleagues can be able to come back to the House the same way they left. Let them come back. This House belongs to them. The House belongs to them. Nobody chased them.
The few opposition legislators who defied the boycott and went back to the House joined members on the right hand of the House to castigate their colleagues for staying out for so long.
That when people walk out of Parliament and they stay away from Parliament, then it can be termed as political activism. I have learnt it from here.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.